Hello, my name is Curt Wehrley. I am the currency strategist and the trader coach covering the New York morning session at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Tuesday, July 31st, 2012. This is a video review of some of the price action we covered in our live New York training room today. First, let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a view showing 15-minute charts for four different currency pairs, each showing price action from the start of today's London trading session, 3 a.m. New York time, up to 7:30 a.m. New York time. One of the first topics I discussed in the early part of my live coaching session today in the FX Bootcamp New York training room was broad British pound strength since today's London open. Now, this set of four charts shows one of the clues pointing to that theme, again, broad British pound weakness. The tops of the upper wicks identified by the blue circles on the Aussie yen chart, CAD yen chart, and Euro yen chart. Those wicks all represent new highs for the day for those pairs. I'm referring to that wick, that high there, this high on the CAD yen, and that high on the Euro yen. By contrast, look at the British pound Japanese yen currency pair on the lower right hand portion of this view. While those other three yen crosses were establishing new highs for the day, the pound yen right here, the pound yen only managed to get back to the middle of this London session trading range, which was in through there. So perhaps sterling is uniquely weak today. Let's see how the British pound is faring against a couple of other major currencies. These two 15-minute charts show price action over the same period of time, 3 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. New York time. Euro pound up on the left-hand part of this view, the euro pound up, pound Swissie down, both in the direction of British pound weakness. So given all that, it was reasonable to explore opportunities to sell a British pound rally today. Now, one logical setup for doing that materialized on the pair known as the many traders as cable. Let's take a look at that. This is a one-hour chart for the pound-dollar currency pair showing price action from yesterday's London open to 9 a.m. New York time today. Notice the horizontal black line in the middle of this chart at the 1.5680 level. That 1.5680 zone seemed to put a floor under cable during yesterday's London and New York sessions, as you can see on the left-hand side of this chart. Also on the right-hand side of the chart, notice how the 5680 zone seemed to put a floor under cable in today's London session. Now, since that prior zone appears to have been broken during the formation of the candle that I'm boxing now with the magenta-colored marker, that same zone might now become resistance. What used to be support might now become resistance. At FX Bootcamp, we often refer to that as roll reversal. Again, roll reversal. Now, there are at least two other prospective sources of resistance you could derive from this chart. One being the hourly 5 EMA that I'm pointing to right now, the dollar sloping maroon colored line that happened to be positioned at the time around the 5680 zone. Also, the other one, the other prospective source of resistance, a Fibonacci study based on the move down from today's high established in the early part of Asian session trading there down to the recent low established below 5660 right there. Let's draw a Fib study of that move down from here to there. The 38.2% Fib retracement level of that prior move down is represented by this horizontal bright red line sitting less than 5 pips above that 1.5680 level. A look at recent price action on a 5-minute chart shows how traders had plenty of chances over a roughly 30-minute period in early New York session trading to take a short trade entry at or near that 1.5680 level. Back now on the hourly chart, let's move this chart forward in time by 1 hour increments. A reasonable profit target for the short that we discussed in the live class was 56.35, just above this combination of the 200-hour exponential moving average and the daily S2 pivot point. Now that sums up what was an opportunity to short a major currency against the U.S. dollar. We also discussed during my coaching session a separate opportunity to long another major currency against the dollar. And the setup might look familiar, the setup to long a currency against the dollar. That setup might look familiar to those of you who watched my New York session video review from last Friday. This 15-minute chart shows most of today's price action on the EUR-USD currency pair. I told the live class that I thought this pair might show some ping-pong-like price action, sometimes up, sometimes down, as the market awaits several key news events over the next 3 days, including Wednesday's FOMC decision, Thursday's ECB decision, and Friday's US NFP report. I discuss in my review, my video review of the July 27th New York session, some evidence that the 1.2275 level, which is right there, and the 1.2325 level, which is near here, that those levels have recently influenced price action on this pair, particularly last week. A long trade entry at 2275 works last Friday, and it worked again today. Entry somewhere in this area, for example, then exit up in here for a profit of roughly 40 pips after spread on that euro long. Again, my name is Curt Wehrley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Tuesday, July 31st.